X-Eryri is a paragliding hike and fly race based in the mountains of Snowdonia in North Wales. This is the first edition of the race, and the format requires the competitors to collect points by travelling to as many of the summits over 2,000 feet as they can in 2 days, moving only by foot or by paraglider. On the last weekend of the summer, after months of waiting, the forecast finally looked promising, and 15 committed pilots assembled on the start line in Llanberis, ready to race.
On your marks, get set, go! Get up there, boys!
Right, the race has started. Me, Bird and Westy, we're up at front. I think three or four people are running up Elio now. We're gonna head up Elidia, up to the quarries. And from there, we're gonna head over into the Ogwen Valley and see what's happening. Isn't that the plan?
That's a good start. Beside me, breathing so
loud. Okay, so we're at the quarries now. Below us, and we're just walking up a little bower right now. Me, Bud and Westy have broken away from the other guys, but they're not too far behind. Alright, the time for tough choices has begun. We're umming and ahhing about trying to launch, and we've sacked it off to extend the walk a little bit longer. This hill in front got really good cloud in front of it. Well, I'm above it, so we're gonna hoof it around, tag it on path, and then get up to the col on the other side of it and hopefully launch there. Okay, so we've chosen our spot, gonna gamble on our first flight. Not sure where we're gonna go yet, but I think my task will be just to tag a guy on from the air and then see what we can do from that. Maybe head into the Canada for a quick loop and then try and get south for more ones. We're gliding over to Pentreath now, hoping this south face with the little wispy clouds above it are going to produce some lift. It's facing the sun and it's got a bit of an eastward aspect, so I'm hopeful. So, we'll just go quickly tick this kind of davit off and then take off again.
After walking up, we found a good launch facing northeast into the Ogwen Valley. After launching, it was clear there was barely any wind, and what little wind there was came from the southeast. At this time of day, the sun was also strongest on the southeast slopes, so they combined to produce some nice thermals, which got us above the summits. I realised this would mean that we could cross the Ogwen Valley and fly along a chain of big southeast facing slopes in the Canadae. and tag some high pointers along the way. My strategy was to play it safe and to stay high. What I really didn't want to do was to lose height, land, and then have to walk back up during the best flying conditions in the afternoon. So I touched down a couple of times to ensure I definitely tagged the summits. When I reached Carnath Llewellyn, I hadn't planned on going any further north, because I knew it would be risky flying closer and closer to the sinky sea air. While I was setting up to relaunch, I saw Westy fly over my head northwards, and saw that he was aiming to get the 250 point bonus for tagging all 15 of the Welsh 3000s. If successful, gambles like this are the ones that win these races, so I knew I had to follow. Especially as I saw Bud had now caught up and was trying to do the same. At this point, the sea breeze had caused a large bank of low cloud to form, which was pushing up against the summits from the north. My hope was a southeast wind would converge with it and form a band of lift where they meet. So I tried to get as high as possible and to surf along this line of convergence. It was really weak and basically just prolonged my descent long enough for me to get to the farthest summit before I turned around to head back south to where the air was working better. Bud and Westy, who were lower down, were less lucky and got stuck in this sinky sea air, causing them to have to land and walk. Meanwhile, conditions were really good as I made it back to the Ogwen Valley. Nice predictable thermals allowed me to hop from summit to summit, mop up another four, and get some easy points. I was a bit concerned about recrossing the Ogwen Valley and doing the long interwind glide to get over the gliders onto the southeast faces on the other side. I could see on the lake that the sea breeze had pushed around the corner and was now coming up the Ogwen Valley. So I chose to backtrack and cross where I thought the sea breeze and the southeast wind might converge. Thankfully, this formed a nice bridge across the valley and gave me a really lifty glide. I reached the other side with plenty of height and found a good line of thermals. I made a mistake after going out to take Trivan because I knew I didn't have enough height to get back to the sunny south side and ended up landing on a narrow ridge on the shady lee side to the north. The breeze had washed out on this side and there were no thermals. Thankfully, I hadn't lost too much height, so I packed up as fast as I could and scrambled up the ridge. There were several people flying overhead and staying up easily, so I knew it was working well. I tagged a little hour on foot before looking to find somewhere that I could relaunch from to head south towards Snowdon.
Okay, so GoPro ran out of battery, I've just charged it up. Amazing flight in the Kanedai, landed on the back of the glider in the Lee. I had to hike up, tagged a little hour, about to launch, hopefully into this convergence, and then head out towards the Morwens. Sea breezing on the to the west,
as you can see.
Lots of low cloud on that side, high cloud on this side. Woohoo! That's Snowdon over there. Left it, and now I'm heading into the Morwens. I'm in a nice line of convergence at the moment. Amazing cloud line. Cool, well I've done the Man of Mao now and the Man of Mao North Top, which is this quarry. And then I'm going to try and do some more of the Morwens, Morwen Mao and Morwen back. Yourself, it's alright. Just like earlier when I crossed the Ogwen Valley, the same thing happened. The sea breeze front had come up the Llanberis Pass and had lifted the air to form a bridge that allowed me to easily cross onto Crib Goch.
Here, the sea breeze and the thermals from the southern slopes are converging strongly over the ridges and allow for some incredible cloud surfing. After ticking Snowdon, which was the final summit that I needed to get the bonus for the Welsh 3000s, my new goal was to try and fly over into the Molwens. It would normally be a crux because it involves a fairly long crossing over the Gwynant, which is a low and wide valley and means the sea breeze can flood up easily, so getting the timing right is quite important. The forecast was interesting today because it accurately showed the sea breezes, one from the southwest, the northwest and the northeast. You can see the effect that they have on the thermals as they push in throughout the afternoon, with warm colours showing good thermic air and colder colours showing the humid sinky sea air. Between 2 and 4 o'clock the sea breezes collide and form a line of convergence that's perfectly positioned over the Molwens. You can see in the line of clouds it formed as I was flying. So I just followed this all the way over to the town of Blaenau-Festiniog. Low in this convergence it felt tricky to locate the thermals and the direction they drifted in would change, so I had to search around a fair bit to get re-established. At this point I checked the live tracking to see what everyone was up to, and I saw that if I got to Manod Mao I might also get the bonus for going the furthest south and the furthest east. By now the convergence pushed southwards by the north-easterly wind, as this more noticeable drift in the thermal shows. Unfortunately, after tagging Molwyn Mawr, this wind was now flushing over the plateau, so I decided to land high and walk.
We've landed. We're in the Molwyns. I think I failed to record another landing. Just had a really wicked little flight that's just mopped up a load of points. My next objective is Knicht, which is over there. I'm climbing! Woohoo! About 6 p.m. Still working! The launch from down on Clink, down there. Oh, I've missed another landing. But this is me landing on Mol Hebog. Okay, steep. It's pretty spectacular up here. I'm so far from Paraglide. As the day wore on, the flying conditions started to visibly weaken. I knew that I had to walk quickly to get to the summit of Knicht in order to relaunch in time. I was in a rush because the convergence had continued to move southwards and was only just within reach from Knicht. As I glided off, I felt really lucky to connect with it and get that final climb that was needed to make the long crossing over what would have been awkward terrain to land on the slopes of Moel Hebog. At this point, the wind had begun to die off and the late sun had lost its power. So my aim now was just to get set up for making it back to Llanberis and the finishing line the next day. So I made my final glide from Moel Hebog towards the Nantlí Ridge and to look for somewhere to set up camp.
Well, I found a camping spot. Here it is. Lovely flat spot. Water nearby, phone signal, and a really pretty amazing view. Can't ask for much more. We're setting up tents now.
Hey,
Nathan's come.
Made it.
You found me.
Found him again. Always do.
Pretty beautiful spot.
Look at this.
There's Nathan. Nathan started cooking us breakfast. It's 6 a.m. Gives me time to sort the kit out, and then race starts at 7:30.
All right,
7:30's happened. Hey guys,
see you later, mate.
You're off too. Look at this. Trying to land on this slope here as high as I can. Looks quite steep. Forward launching time. And you know it matters. Doing what you let under your skin. Go to the taste. Would you step back from the fire? Look at this. Wow. Hold everything back. Woo-hoo. All emotions stand aside. There with Will, flew down, landed here. Will's just walking up now. I'm gonna walk up Morkinorion, and then I'm gonna try and take the last three into Stone Range, try and get the bonus. Will had a really good day yesterday. Flying the horseshoe, how was it?
Just amazing, mind blowing. Lots of words.
Yeah, I felt pretty similar as well. Yeah. So we're on the top of Morkinorion. A bit cloudy at the moment, as you can see. Thin layer of cloud, I think. It's coming and going, so we're just going to get in that window and then pop off. No one around you, no one to understand you, no one to hear your calls. Look through all your dark corners, when you're backed up against the wall. Step back from the light of fire. Me and Will have made it up onto Moylalia, our final summit. Step back from the light of